Welcome to this video on VLSI verification and testing. So after the VLSI chips are fabricated, they are tested to detect if any fault is present in the chip during the manufacturing process. So it may happen that after the manufacturing process is complete, the chip may have some fault. So they are tested and only the good chips are sent to the customer. So we use various fault models to detect the test. So the most common fault model is the single stuck at fault. So in the single stuck at fault, we have basically three assumptions. We assume that only single line is faulty and the faulty line is either set either to 0 or 1. Also the fault can be at the input or output of a gate. So if you see this circuit, then we have all these possible lines. So this A from here to here, then B from here to here, then here there is a fan out or diversion. So D line is from here to here, then C line is from here to here, then this E line is from here to this gate, then this F line is from this gate to this AND gate, then this G line is from AND gate, from NAND gate to this point, then H line is from this point to the input of this NAND gate. Then I line is from this point to the input of this gate. So this is called as fan out. So G is fan outing into 2, H and I. Similarly, A is getting divided into 2, C and D. And B is getting divided into E and F. So this is called as fan out. This is called as fan out. So this diversion where A is getting divided into 2 lines, C and D, is called as fan out. So we have all these lines A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, and final line is the output line Z. So as per the single stuck at fault model, the fault can be at any of the lines. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So there are 12 possible fault locations because we have 12 possible lines, 12 possible locations. And by second assumption, the faulty line can be either at 0 or 1. So all the faulty line can be at either 0 or 1. So there are 24 possible faults. There are 24 possible faults. Let's suppose the fault is that this H is stuck at 0. So I am writing it as S dash A dash 0. So this H line is stuck at 0. So even if this G value is equal to 1, this H value will be equal to 0. This is the stuck at fault. So this H value will always be 0. G can be anything. G can be anything. This H value will always be 0. So if this H value is always 0, then the output of this NAND gate will always be equal to 1. So J will always be equal to 1 because this H is stuck at 0. So it will not change its value even if G is equal to 1. So when G is equal to 0, then obviously H is equal to 0. And when G is equal to 1, then also H is equal to 0 only. So let's suppose we have A equal to 1 and B equal to 1. This is the initial input that we are giving. A is equal to 1 or let's change it. Let's say B equal to 0. So this is the initial input that we are giving. A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 0. So if A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 0, then obviously C is equal to 1 because we have assumed that C is not at any fault. D will also be equal to 1 because we have assumed that D is not at any fault. E is equal to 0 because we have assumed that E is also not at any fault. And F will also be equal to 0. So this is 1 and 0, so G will be equal to 1, but H will be equal to 0 only. H will be equal to 0 only because of this. C is equal to 1. So J is equal to 1. Let's, if H was not, if H was not at fault, then this C was 1, H was also 1. If this H was not at fault, then our correct input should be 0. So I am writing in bracket the correct input. So this is for with fault and this is for without fault. Okay, without fault G is equal to 1, so H should be also equal to 1. So this output should be 0 without fault. But if there is fault, then H is forever stuck at 0 only. So if H is forever stuck at 0, so J will be equal to 1. So J is equal to 1 with fault and 0 without fault. So in bracket I have written the value without the fault. Similarly, if I will be equal to 1, F is 0, so K will be equal to 1. Okay, so there is no fault here. So we have not considered any fault. So the output of this circuit, see, with fault, the output of this circuit, Z is equal to 0. So Z is equal to 0 with fault. Because with fault, K is equal to 1 and this J is equal to 1. So Z is equal to 0. But without fault, Z is equal to 1. So we can write Z equal to 0 and in bracket 1, where 0 is the value with fault, 1 is the value without fault. So as you can see, in this circuit there were 12 possible fault locations and 24 possible faults. So we took example of one stuck, this H line is stuck at 0. So when H is stuck at 0, then output is 0 with fault. If suppose this fault was not there, then output should be 1 without fault. But because of the fault, that H line is stuck at 0. So this G is getting divided into 2. So if G is 1, I is equal to 1 and H should also be equal to 1. But because of this stuck at fault, H is equal to 0 only. So if suppose, let's take another example. We have this, say, AND gate A, B and C. These are the, this is the AND gate. A and B are the inputs and C is the output. So there are 3 possible fault locations, 1, 2 and 3. 3 possible fault locations and 6 possible faults. So A can be stuck at 0 or A can be stuck at 1. B can be stuck at 0 or B can be stuck at 1. C can be stuck at 0 or C can be stuck at 1. Suppose if C is stuck at 0, if C is stuck at 0, then even if A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 1, the output will be 0 only because this C line is stuck at 0. Suppose it is permanently connected to some ground. It is permanently connected to some ground or it is shorted to some ground due to manufacturing defect. C line is shorted to ground due to some manufacturing defect. We are not going into the detail of the manufacturing effect, but suppose C is forever equal to 0. So even if A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 1, this C output will remain at 0. So to detect this fault, what we will do is, to detect this fault, C is stuck at 0. What we will have to do is, we will have to say A equal to 1 and B equal to 1. So if A equal to 1 and B equal to 1, then we will test the output C. If this C output is 0, then we can say that C is at fault. On suppose, on the other hand, suppose if C is forever at 1, if C is forever stuck at 1, S dash A dash 1, if C is forever stuck at 1, then to test this fault, what we will do is, we will give the input here 0 and 0. So when both the inputs are 0, output should be equal to 0. But if C is stuck at 1 forever, then it will not be 0. So for this stuck at 1 fault, the input should be this also 0 and this also 0.
Now suppose
if this line A is stuck at 0. If this line A is stuck at 0, then to check this, what we will do is, again we will give the input A equal to 1 and B equal to 1. We will give the input A equal to 1 and B equal to 1. So the output C should be equal to 1, because both the inputs are 1 of the AND gate. So the output should be 1. But if this line is stuck at 0, then output will be 0. So now we know that this line is at some fault. So in this way, we can test the circuit for fault also. So we design the test vector to test the fault. Like to test this C equal to 0, we gave here 1 1. So if this is equal to 1, then C should be equal to 1. But if this line is stuck at 0, or if this line is stuck at 0, then it means that our circuit is having wrong output, or the output is not correct. So in this way, the stuck at fault model can be done. So if you have any doubt, you can post your comment in the comment box. Please like and share the video and subscribe the channel, and I will also share more examples on the stuck at fault, single stuck at fault, and also multiple stuck at fault, where multiple lines can also be at fault. So thank you and best of luck.